As per the available information with me, Pepsi came into existence way back in 1917. At present, 150 other chambers and associations are affiliated to it, and there are about 3,290 members. Pepsi is a formidable force in promoting the growth of trade, commerce and industry in Andhra Pradesh. I would like to express my thanks for inviting me and my colleagues for this event and giving us an opportunity to interact with the members of Pepsi. I would like to first give a broad picture of the achievements of the Income Tax Department, Andhra Pradesh, during the last financial year, that is 2012-13. During the last financial year, in spite of a lot of constraints, we have been able to achieve a collection of 29,723 crores, as against the collection of 25,834 crores in the preceding financial year. The growth rate of the Andhra Pradesh region was 15.1% against an all India average of 12.85%. The corporate taxes growth rate was 7% and the IT growth rate was 32.5%. The state of Andhra Pradesh ranks fifth in revenue collection in India. During the last financial year, 19.65 lakh returns, including 11.73 e-file returns, were received. A total refund of about 3,079 crores have been issued in 2.35 lakh cases. The Directorate General of Investigation has also done very good work during the last financial year. The total disclosure in the searches conducted in the last financial year was ₹1,336 crores, as against a disclosure of 819 crores in the preceding financial year. Apart from that, concealment detected was 410 crores in the last financial year, as against 355 crores in the preceding financial year. As far as surveys under Section 133A is concerned, surveys were conducted in 524 cases in the preceding financial year 12-13, leading to detection of undisclosed income of about 796 crores, as against 505 surveys conducted in the preceding financial year, leading to detection of concealment of 595 crores in the preceding financial year. I would like to highlight certain issues which we faced in the preceding in the financial year 2012-13. One of the issues I would like to highlight is the payment of self-assessment tax. It has been noticed over the years after the e-filing of returns that a large number of assessees do not pay the self-assessment tax. And this number, the amount of such unpaid self-assessment tax has been increasing over the years. This leads to a lot of work which has to be done by the department in following up for collection of the taxes. So my request is that the members should take the initiative in educating among themselves as well as the professionals who are part of this Pepsi to advise the businessmen who are members of this of Pepsi to adopt the right approach towards the payment of self-assessment tax. Because I came across certain cases where, in spite of lot of opportunity allowed, notices issued, the tax will remain unpaid during the financial year. Now I think this section has been amended, and I think where the self-assessment tax is not paid, the returns will be treated as defective. So to avoid returns being declared defective, all assessees should pay the legitimate, you know, whatever self-assessment tax is due as per the returns. Another issue is the declaration of income under the head capital gains. Particularly section 50C, which requires the consideration received for the sale to be adopted at a particular value as per the section. So many SSEs do not take that section into consideration and do not disclose the right amount for computing the capital gain. There are also SSEs who do not declare the capital gains at all. So we have collected a lot of information in this regard. So my appeal is that all SSEs should pay the capital gains correctly in accordance with law. Then another thing I have observed that though there has been improvement over the years, that whenever a survey is conducted under section 133A, it generally leads to detection of some undisclosed income. Now this indicates that SSEs are not declaring the income truly and correctly, otherwise this situation would not have been there. Then same thing has been noticed in the case of inspections done in TDS cases, where we find that in many cases after deducting the taxes, the same is not deposited into the central government account. So my advice is that all deductors should scrupulously follow the provisions of the Act and deposit the taxes within the due dates. Apart from the enforcement function of the department has been giving a lot of attention to taxpayer services also. In Andhra Pradesh, at present, I think 5 ASK centers are functioning at various places, including Hyderabad, Vizag, Vijayawada, and at Nizamabad, where in the month of March, we had inaugurated the ASK Kendra. Then department has been also paying a lot of attention to settlement of grievances. There is a special cell on grievances in the office of the CCIT 1 Hyderabad, headed by the additional CIT technical, and also an online grievance portal, namely CP Grants, where the SSEs can file their grievances if the same are not addressed by the lower authorities. During the last financial year, we have received 215 grievance petitions and 120 grievances were disposed by the special cell on grievances.